Hello viewers, welcome to the next video in the tutorial series of E framework. In this video we are going to discuss more about grid view. Okay, so let's recap what we have discussed in the previous tutorial on the grid view. So we have discussed about what is grid view, then we have discussed about pagination and sorting within the grid view, then we have looked into the grid column and into which we have discussed about how we can configure data column and action column. And similarly, we discussed about configuring different properties of the grid view like header and footer, etc. So what we are going to cover in this tutorial, we are going to look into the content options property for the grid view. We are going to cover how we can write the custom data column class to render the column value in the grid view. Then so in the previous tutorial what we have used active data provider, right? But in this tutorial we are going to also see how we can use the array data provider and the SQL data provider in the grid view. Then we are going to discuss about using filters and search in the grid view. Okay, so now I would just move on to the code and then we would start looking into the examples. Okay, so we have the record controller into which we have written the action grid, right? So if I run on the browser /grid, this is the view we are getting. Okay, so now let's go to resultgrid.php. Okay, so here first we are going to discuss about the content options property. So in a column what you can do, okay, I would just right now comment this thing. Now I would just uncomment this. So what is content options? So content options is configured to provide the HTML options to the column. So right now what I have done, I have given the style as background color yellow and visibility is visible. So now let's look at the output on the browser. See, so we have the status column having the background as yellow, right? Now let's say I change the visibility to hidden and now let's look at the output on the browser. So the column data is not visible anymore. So this is how you can use content options to configure the HTML options for the column. Now we are going to discuss about the custom data column class. So what we have seen that we can configure the value in this way and we can configure the value in this way as well. Now there is another way of rendering the column value. So what we are going to do, we are going to comment this and we have written a custom data column class which is status data column. So I'm just going to open this. So this would extend the data column class, which is actually the default class for a grid data column. Okay, so in this what I have done, I have overridden this method render data cell content which are having these params as the argument $model, $key and $index. Okay, so this is the row model actually. For the row, what is the model that is there? This is the key associated with the data model. And this is the index for the row. So like 0, 1, 2, 3. So like that we have the index. So what we are doing here is we are doing the same thing what we have done here. But now this is done using the custom data column class. So what it is doing, it is just checking the same thing. If the status is active, return active, otherwise return inactive. So now let's look at the output on the browser. See, so we have got, okay, status column is hidden right now. So let's go here and make it visible. So we have got the output here. So this is how you can use the custom data column class if you want to display value in cases where, I mean, you don't have to display the value directly. Like you have to check some conditions and then you have to render some value based on that condition. So in that case, in those scenarios, the usage of custom data column class is very useful. Moving ahead, let's talk about how we can use array data provider with grid view. Okay, so first thing what I have done is I have created this action. Then I am calling this view file result array grid. So let's go to this file. Okay, before that I would like to call out. So here in the result grid, we have used the active data provider. Now we are using the array data provider. Okay, so first thing what we have to do, we have to pass all the results to this property, all models. So what we are doing, we are having the instance of query and then we are getting all the records from the client table and then assigning it to this property, and then we are configuring the pagination and the sort. So the key difference between the active data provider and array data provider, apart from the type of result set that we have, like in active data provider we have the active records and in array data provider we have the result array, right? But here you have to first get all the models from the table and then pagination would be applied. So assume you have 20 records in the database and you have the page size as 4, right? So you would have 5 pages. Now let's say you are using the array data provider. So first you have to get all the records here and then the pagination would be applied. But if you are using active data provider, then you would get only the first 4 records. So this is the difference between using active data provider and array data provider, apart from the type of result set that we are getting. Okay, so here we have provided all models, configure pagination, configure the sort, right? And one more change which we have to make is, so in the status data column we are accessing status like this and not as an object. So let's look at the output on the browser. So I would change to array slash hyphen grid. Okay, so we have got the result set based on array data provider. So this is how you can use the array data provider with the grid view. Next, we are going to look into the usage of SQL data provider. So here I have created an action called action SQL grid and this is the view file. So let's look into this file. So here what we have done, we have first get the count of the records in the database, then we instantiate the query, and here we are calling the SQL data provider. We are passing the SQL over here, so it would get all the records from the database. This is the total count property, so we are passing this count property here, and then we are configuring the pagination and the sort, right? So now let's look at the output on the browser. So here I would change it to SQL hyphen grid. So we have got the results using the SQL data provider. So this is how you can use the SQL data provider with the grid view. Okay, moving ahead, let's talk about the filters and search form. Okay, so for that what I have done is using GII, what I have done, I have used this CRUD generator, and I have the model, we have the model class with it, with us, right? The client model. So I have created a search model class, I have created a client controller and the views corresponding to the client model. So here I have the client controller with me, right? And this is the action index, and I have this client search model which actually extends the client model. I would discuss about it in detail when we see how the filters work. Okay, so let's first go to action index. So here we are instantiating the client search model, then we are calling the search function in this model, and we are passing the query params over here, and then we are rendering the index file, and we are passing the search model and the data provider to it. So this is the index.php what we have. Okay, so first let's load this view file. So here I would say, so client controller, so client slash index. Okay, so this is the index file. Okay, so we have the ID, name, email, status, and these are the two custom columns which I have added. I would discuss about them later on in the tutorial. So first let's see how does the filter works. So first we have, so what we have to do, we have to configure this property over here. So this is, so we have passed the search model to the index file, right, in the action. So we are passing this search model as the filter model, right? So because of which we have these filters displayed over here. Okay, now regarding filters, there are a couple of key points which I would like to discuss about. Okay, so if you are not providing any filter property specifically to the column, by default the filter would be a text field. So this is a text field, so ID, name, email. So for them we are not passing any filter property. Also, I mean, we are not configuring any filter property, but for status what I have done, I have passed this filter property. So if you pass an array, a drop down list would be displayed. So right now if you see, we have the drop down list displayed over here, right? So okay, so now let's see how the flow works. So as soon as you type something over here, so let's say if I am typing Harry, I am pressing tab, right, the grid is updated, right? So how does it work? So I would type Harry here and press tab, and AJAX request is fired. So if we go to this request, so R is client slash index, so action index would be called. So here what we are doing, we are instantiating client search, and then we are reading the query params and then calling the search function. So let's go into this search function. So here we are passing the query params, we are instantiating, we are getting the active query here, and then we are instantiating the active data provider and passing the active query to it. Okay, then we are loading the params. So in the request we have these params. So we have client search name as Harry. So these those params would be loaded into the model. Okay, then we validate here, and if the validation fails, we are simply returning the data provider. But if the validation pass, then we are calling and filter where on different properties. So here we are checking for ID, but in the request we have no input for ID, so it would not add anything to the query. Next is the name. So we are passing the name in the input, right? So this would just append to the, this would be just appended to the query. So name like Harry, and then we are returning the data provider from this function. And finally, this data provider is passed to the view file, and on the view file we are passing the data provider here. So in this way the results are filtered and the grid got updated. Okay, so this is about the name. Okay, so now remove name and let's select status. So here I would select active. So the records which are active are displayed. Now if I select inactive, so we have got only one result. So let's see the change which we have done for status filter. So here we have put in this condition. So status equal to the status in the input. So this is how the status, the results are filtered based on the status. Okay, now moving ahead, let's discuss about these two custom columns. Okay, so why I have introduced these two columns is because I want to discuss about one more concept, which is the format. So by default, when any column value is displayed, the default format is text, but the grid view supports other format like raw, HTML or the date format. So this is the custom column which I have added, the image, right? So what I am returning here, I am just returning an image which I have added inside the web folder. So this function, the get alias function, actually it gives me the path corresponding to at web alias. I would discuss about aliases in the further tutorials, but for now you can understand it, understand alias as the representation of a file path or URL, so that you don't have to remember hard-coded file path. So here in the web folder I have this image. So I'm just getting this image over here, returning the image with the width as 70 pixel and a height as the 70 pixel, but I'm passing the format as HTML. So that's why we are getting the image over here. But let's say if I change this format to text, which is the default format, and let's see the output. See, so we are simply getting the HTML code and no image is being rendered. So when you have to render the image, you have to pass the format as HTML over here. Going ahead, let's talk about the date format. So I have added this column created on, and here we are returning the current Unix timestamp, but we are passing the format as raw. So now let's look at the output on the browser. So we are getting the Unix timestamp only. It's not, because it's raw format, right? So now let's change it to the date format. So I'm just passing it as date, and now let's look at the output on the browser. See, so the date is formatted. So this is how you can configure the format parameter for a column. So okay, one more thing, the search form. So yeah, here I have just commented it right now. So I'm just uncommenting this. So if I refresh the screen, so I would just remove all this right now. Okay, so this is the search form which is generated using the GII tool. So let's go to this file. Okay, so this is the search file. Okay, so we have simply the form over here with fields as ID. So I am just removing this ID field. So we have name, email and status. So if I pass Harry over here, so the results got filtered. So this works same as the filters which we have on top of each column. So it depends on your requirement whether you want to use the search form or you want to use the filters. So let's say take a scenario where you have some columns which you don't want to display on grid, but you want to filter the data based on them, right? So in those cases you have to use the this search form, but apart from it you can simply use the filters to filter the results on the grid. Okay, so I think that's all for this tutorial. I hope this tutorial is useful to you. In case you have any questions, you can post them in the comment section or you can send an email to us at info@ushainformatique.com. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and click subscribe to the channel for more such videos. Thank you very much.